What's going on, guys? As promised, I said I would do a little bit of a video on using the Harbor Freight dual action orbital here. I have used it a good bit on our Corvette, but I have yet to use it on anything else really. So I'm gonna do a good paint correction on the Monte Carlo here. I'm gonna start on the roof because it's the flattest surface and it's probably gonna be the easiest thing to show you guys. So just to give you guys an idea of what I start with, I have Meguiar's Ultimate Compound. I would sand it up, but I ran it over on accident. So I have Ultimate Compound. This is like the most aggressive. I really don't use this that much. I would probably pair it with a red pad. This is a rotary pad from Meguiar's. Works on the DA as well. It's just a little different. Like I said, I don't use it a whole lot. I use it for like headlights sometimes and stuff, dirty work like that. So I will not be using that today. I don't think we own anything really that is rough enough that would need such a harsh abrasive like this. So we're going to be putting that aside. Maybe use it some other time. I'll do a close-up video right now and just show you guys what the paint looks like on the Monte Carlo here. It's not horrible, but you can see it when you get in the light. I'll try and show you guys. Just watch the light there, you can see where I have swirls. I think if we move back this way. It's light swirling. It's not horrible, but it's not great. You can see them and it bugs me. Let's move towards the front. I thought there was some up here too. So, decent bit of swirls in the paint. If you look on the edge here, there are just some scratches from previous owner, maybe from me. So, starting with something so light with scratches, I am going to start right away with Meguiar's Swirl Remover 2.0. You can also use their Ultimate Swirl Remover. I've heard mixed. I've heard the Ultimate's actually a little bit better. I've had good results with this so far. So, with that, I'm going to use a yellow pad. So this is, again, this is a Meguiar's yellow pad. It looks dirty, it's been cleaned, it's fine, it's just been worn. So, clean yellow pad, swirl remover. We're going to follow that up with another yellow pad. Yellow pad is like the medium cutting pad. Red pad is the most aggressive cutting pad that Meguiar's has to offer. And then we have a black finishing pad. So after I do my swirl remover, I'm going to follow that up with Ultimate Polish, again, on a yellow pad. And then finally, after that, I'm going to finish it. Fully finished with a high-tech yellow wax. You could also use a sealant before that if you'd like. I prefer just to use wax. I keep my vehicles pretty well waxed, so that works for me. All the while, I'm going to be wearing earmuffs still, just because the Harbor Freight buffer is pretty loud. So let's get started here with swirl remover and our yellow pad, and we'll see what we can do. Alright guys, so we have the pad here, just shaking up our swirl remover. First off, I'm gonna get a good amount on here. We want to prime our pad, make sure it's all good to go. We don't want it to be dry. It can lead to swirls and set us in the wrong direction. So we'll get it primed, get a good layer on there. Use your finger, just kind of work it into the pad and try to get as much of the pad covered as you can. The more coverage you get, the better. After we do that, then I usually like to do four or five dots around the outside and one in the center. So one there, one there, one there, and one there. Obviously very well placed and measured out. Last thing I'll do is then I'll take a quick detailer. I'm using Meguiar's right now. People either love it or hate it. It doesn't seem to last as long as some others, and it doesn't go as far. But I'm just going to use it for this instance. I'm just going to use a quick spray on here to make sure the whole thing is covered and wet. So that'll do. That's all you need. And I believe it's time for us to get going. So first we'll just kind of dab it around. Get our little 2x, I'm gonna try and work in, you know, 2x2 foot spots to 3x3. Once you get that far, you can put it on anywhere from 1.5 to 2 on the selector back here, and we'll just start moving it around and get it all spread out. So we got our working area all set. As you can see, we're gonna try and stick to this area and really work in there. So as I mentioned in the initial video with this buffer, I have the marks around the outside. I'm gonna turn it up to about 4.5 on the speed, and I'm gonna apply anywhere from 10 to 15 pounds of pressure. You want the pad to continue moving, but you don't want it to stop, and you want it to you don't want it to just freely run either. So 10 to 15 pounds of pressure. Probably start off a little lighter and then work into it as you get more comfortable, but that's what we're gonna start at. I'm gonna work this whole area. As you're gonna see, I'm gonna do passes this way. I'm gonna go about 1 inch per second roughly. So I'll go up, down, 50% carryover on that last pass, up, down, all the way down. And then I will do the same thing down and back. 50% down and back, and I'll do that until the area is completely covered. So I'm gonna put my earmuffs on here and start. You guys will hear, I'll let you guys hear it first how loud this thing is. So starting at 2, I'm gonna pick it up all the way to 4.5. Alright, so as you can see, we still have our Swirlex on there. Now, I'm going to be taking that off with our rag here, or our microfiber. That is a clean microfiber, it just looks dirty. Looks like we've got a good bit out. There are some swirls, some finer scratches in there. Those can generally be taken out with polish. Alright guys, so I hit the whole roof with Swirlex. It is time for polish. Prior to getting a dual action, I actually never really used polish. I was more of a wax. I always did everything by hand. I was a firm believer that you could do just about anything by hand, which isn't wrong. It's just, generally speaking, it's going to take a longer time to get it done. So a dual action really, it cuts the time that you spend detailing a vehicle, and it really makes it an easier process. Generally speaking, then that results in just better outcome. So same thing here with the polish. I have my polishing pad. This is a pad that I personally use for polishing. I have a separate one for compounding and swirling, and then polishing and then wax as well. So same thing. We're gonna get a good bit on there. We're gonna rub it all in. Polish is a little different. It's a little more wet. Had something in there. It's a little more wet, so when you're moving it around, it's going to kind of stay on your finger, and it's going to make your finger, it just sticks to your finger like a liquid. It's different, but I'm a huge fan of polish after not using it for so many years. It just really, really brings out depth in paint prior to wax. And if you're somebody that's using a polish after only using wax for a while, like myself, you're really going to like the outcome. So gonna do our 5 little dabs. These dabs, not the dabs you guys are thinking of. Sorry, Cam Newton. 5 little dabs there. Again, our little spritz of detailer. And we're ready to go. Again, earmuffs on. You can do it without earmuffs, it's just easier on my ears, so I'm gonna continue doing it that way. Spread around like so, put it on 2, and then spread it out. So when you're spreading it like that, you want to get a good idea of where you're working with. And then once I did my second passes there, I did probably I went back over maybe an eighth to a quarter of what I already did. You just want to make sure you don't miss anything. So that's what I personally do. If you guys have a method that you prefer, you know, whatever works for you. So I'm going to continue polishing here and get this section done. And we'll try to compare. It's really hard to compare the depth on a camera, but I'm impressed with the depth, especially in metallics like this. Like I was saying earlier, it's just kind of a car I don't really care about that much. But it really, really brings out the paint and the metallics, and it kind of makes it a nice car to look at. So we're going to start polishing. Same method as before. I'll probably stop down to about 4 in terms of speed on this guy. But yeah, same method. Going to go down, up, you know, at about an inch per second, or, you know, not, I wouldn't say an inch per second, but you want to go probably an inch every 2 to 3 seconds, somewhere in there. So I did basically the same thing there. I did 10 to 15 pounds of pressure. As I said, I stopped it down to about 4. With polish, it seems to be it doesn't seem to be as great of a lubricant. So you can see that the pad was kind of slowing down as I was buffing. So I'm going to clean this all off. I'm going to finish the panel over here on the right side, and then we'll finish with our wax. Alright, so I just finished up polishing the whole roof. I finished the other side here, as you guys didn't see on camera, but you saw the right side of the roof. And I just want to give you guys an idea of what we're looking at now. There are some small little imperfections in the roof still. The swirl got a lot of the big swirls out in the swirl remover, and then the polish does a good job of really taking the edges off on some of those bigger scratches so you can't see them as well. Step back and you have a really nice finish. So that's where we're at now. We're going to finish up with our black pad and our wax. This is where you'd use sealant if you wanted to. We're going to use wax, and we'll see our final result and compare it to the other side, which has not been touched. Alright, so we have our black pad here. We also have our Meguiar's high-tech yellow wax, number 26. Can we just take a second to appreciate how well I got that pad on there? Oh, it doesn't even wobble. There's not really a good way on this backing plate to get that on there, or at least get that on there even, so it's kind of nice when it's on there. Perfect, so just gonna shake it up, same thing as before. Process for wax, I do a little bit differently. Well, to an extent. I'm going to get the pad still primed like it did before. So, pad is primed. I'm just going to spread it all around until we're good. And then our 5 dots, 5 around the center, 1 in the middle again. We're going to go 6 because I suck at making them even. So when I apply wax with a dual action, I'll do the same thing. I'll spread it around. I just want to get our surface area that we're working with covered very well. And we're just spreading this time. So I'm going to stop down to about 1.5 or 2 on here. And I'm just going to spread it around, make sure it's covering everything, work it in a little bit. But we're not trying to correct anything. This is just wax. It has no cleaners or abrasives in it. So. There will be no point in us trying to correct the paint with it. If we were using a cleaner wax, then we could do that to try and finish out with some of the smaller swirls, but just wax here, we already took care of the swirls. So, starting at 2 on the speed. I don't know if you guys can see that. I'll try and get the camera to focus for you guys. So, 2. We're going to just spread it around and get it all finished up here, and we'll check out the end result. Thank you. All right, so we got our coat of wax on there. Just gonna do your preferred method of removing. I like to do circles. Some people say circles bring in swirl marks. If you have a clean towel, you're not really gonna introduce, anytime you make contact with paint, you're gonna introduce swirl marks. But if you have a clean towel, you're gonna reduce your risk. You can do swirls, you can do up and down, just to make sure you get everything. I prefer swirls, so I'm gonna continue with swirls. Or circles, hopefully not swirls. We'll continue with circles, not swirls. So, got all that taken care of. Our surface is clean. This car actually looks pretty good. I was considering getting rid of it, but if I can get the whole thing to clean up like this, I might consider keeping it for a while. All right, we're on the other side now. You can get an idea of what the swirls looked like before. Just keeping an eye on the light, there's a good bit. The car was woman-owned before me. Not that that means anything, but I was told that she had her purse up here a lot and just didn't really care too much, which is fine. It was her car. I didn't have to buy it. So you can see all the swirls there. That's what the other side looked like before. Now let's go to the other side. So here's the other side. There are some deeper scratches in there. Those are, in my opinion, not worth chasing after. There's not enough clear coat there really to get into them. I'm sure if I really wanted to, I could. It's just kind of a risk. So as you can see, all those major swirls, try and step back a bit so you can see, all the major swirls are gone. All the major imperfections are gone, everything like that. The paint looks really good. I don't know if you can get an idea on the camera. It has some pretty impressive depth to that metallic. I'm not a huge silver fan, despite this car on the WS6. I kind of like other colors, but it really, the Meguiars, or not the Meguiars, well, the Meguiars in combination with the Harbor Freight dual action really do a good job. I also did the Corvette. I didn't go as hard on that one. I wanted to take it easy and, you know, not run into any risks of issues. That's a rock chip, but you can see around it, the paint looks really good. So let's go over to the Corvette and take a look at that. It might be a little dusty, but same deal here. It did really good. I used the same method, same products. It brought out the metallics, I think, pretty good. Let's see if we can get it to focus on some of that metallic. It doesn't want to focus, but it did a really good job of bringing that metallic out in the paint. Oh, did we almost get a focus there? So, like I said, I think it was hard, so you can see some of those other swirls. This one was a lot worse than that car even, just previous owner neglect. So, as you can see, it brings out a lot of the depth in the metallic and looks pretty good. Look at that bead. Not raining too hard out yet, but compare that to the other side of the hood that wasn't done. Looks pretty good. You guys are probably wondering who buffs your car and then rolls it outside right before rain. Yeah, that's me! That is what I use, guys. These towels that I use are Chemical Guy towels. I'll put a link to the description if I can find it. I get them on Black Friday. I order them in lots, and then I just use them throughout the summer, the car show season. I really like them. I end up, you know, I toss the dirty ones, or I turn them into like shop rags, and then I wash the clean ones. So I'll put a link down below for those. You guys saw all my Meguiar's products. I'll put links to all of them below as well. The dual action that I'm using will be down there as well. If you guys want to see my unboxing of that and my initial thoughts, be sure to check out the link in the description. That kind of was part one. This is part two. I'm going to be doing a part three. Well, funky fingers. Doing a part three. Where I will show just some upgrades. I talked about those in the first video. I want to pack it with new grease. I want to just make some minor adjustments that I think will make it easier to use. Overall, I think it's a great tool. It's cheap. It runs well. It doesn't have any hiccups. You know, I've used it a good bit now, and it just keeps on going. So I'm really happy with it. Yeah, I don't know. I just wanted to get a video out of how I do it. Maybe some of you guys can use that. I really like the Meguiar's pads. They seem to do very good. I've heard good things about them. So check those out if you don't have pads already. Auto Geek is a good place to go and check out any detailing stuff. That's where I got the pads at. None of this is sponsored. I just wanted to make a video on it because it's, you know, it seems people commonly ask about it. So Yeah, there's a little bit of my process with the Harbor Freight dual action orbital with the 6-inch backing plate and 6-inch pads. If you guys have any questions, be sure to leave them below in the comment section. I'll try to answer all I can. If you like the video and want to see more, please hit that thumbs up button. That really helps me. And if you guys want to see more from my channel, be sure to subscribe. I appreciate you guys tuning in for this one. I will see you guys in the next video.